I'm going to add, I think I want to control your lot as well, Gary.
Oh,
so just
of course you do.
Again, on the app again, I'm just going to add another UK style switch. Today we're going to look at these RetroTouch switches with EnOcean battery-free technology. You do, Gary. You get a little bit excited when it comes to wireless switches. But these ones, what's a problem sometimes, Gary, with these various flavours that are around?
Yeah, some of the manufacturers of these switches, they don't look that pretty and can stand out in a room of being completely different than a switch you normally see at a wall.
Yeah, so the great thing about these ones, so this, first off, they have a glass front,
yeah,
which is something we haven't seen before. So this RetroTouch range matches a range of wiring accessories as well. So that's the first great thing. The second great thing is the EnOcean technology. So the other problem you have with a lot of these kinetic, so let's think, where does it get the power from, Gareth? There's no batteries?
Yeah, there is no batteries and there are no cables in them either. So obviously as we operate the switch, you hear that click. Actually, that is movement, so kinetic energy. The kinetic energy will send a signal, usually a radio frequency signal, but you'll see in this video that also it can work on Bluetooth, and that harvests that energy in order to turn on a receiver or off a receiver.
Yeah, so we've looked at a few flavors of this before, but the problem with a lot of the ones in the market is they're tied to a particular manufacturer.
Yeah.
So imagine you've done a large install in a house and suddenly that manufacturer is no longer there or not supporting that range of products. You could end up in a challenging conversation with the customer. The great thing about EnOcean was the original wireless battery-free technology protocol, and it is supported across lots of manufacturers. As we'll see here today, we've got modules that receive the signal from different manufacturers, and they obviously there is a degree of compatibility. There's a few different flavors depending on where you are in the world, and we're also going to introduce this new Bluetooth version as well.
And that's fantastic, isn't it, that we know that because so many manufacturers are behind the EnOcean part of the technology, that will continue on. And also you hinted at there that other electrical accessories that match this, so you can get a socket outlet in exactly the same design, so therefore your switches and sockets in that room will actually match.
That's it. So shall we have a look how it works?
So let's bring it up.
So the first one we're going to look at is this simple switching module here, and this uses an 868 megahertz wireless communication protocol.
Okay.
So here's a switch. So look, if you look at that,
that's beautiful, isn't it?
Glass front. So at the moment, it doesn't do anything.
Okay, that's not very good then, is it?
You can hear that click. That's the energy harvesting going on. So we're now going to pair it to this module here. So this module here, so imagine this was, say, out in the garden.
Okay, so this is for garden lighting. I see you've got some IP rated LED strip up here. This is mounted on a post, but of course you want to switch it from back inside the house.
Exactly, so I'm going to put this receiver module into pairing mode. So press that three times.
Okay.
You'll see the LED strip is flashing. There's a red LED coming out, and then I simply press this switch, and there you go, I've paired it.
No. Wow.
That's incredibly easy. No apps involved. That always keeps Gary happy.
It does keep me happy. So simple process, and we can go on and pair other switches to it. So we make two-way intermediate and add loads more switches. But that's incredibly simple, and you can see it now, can't you? Feed runs around the garden, goes to a post, and then you've got that switch at the back door.
Yeah, or you're in a challenge and retrofit situation in an existing house.
Yeah.
You don't want to rip up a expensive wooden floor, or it's just generally difficult to run a cable route. That's got you covered. You've got another version there, Gary, which is actually a dimming version as well, haven't
you? Yeah, so we've set this up. Obviously, we've got the box in here. We've got a receiver in there, and we've got some dimmable LED downlight. So I can do exactly the same process. We've paired it already. You'll see plenty of pairing processes throughout the video, so haven't paired this one. So we've got the ability to operate the switch, so we can have it coming on and off as if it's a normal switch.
Okay.
So let's turn it on.
Yep.
Okay, and then
I'll hold it,
hopefully we'll see that this will dim down. So as we look here, so we got it and back up, and then we can dim all the way down again by just simply holding the button.
Yeah, and that's because that's an inline dimmer, it's got a neutral supply of that dimmer as well. You do get, should I suggest, a better quality dimming than you might do with a conventional rotary dimmer, where you're always in that trade-off situation between the fixture and the dimmer. That's good, Gary, but what if I wanted also to control this outdoor light from the same switch as your downlight?
So I put my kitchen lights on, or we could perhaps suggest that this was LED strip now, and we say under kitchen cupboards. So the main lights in the kitchen and whatever. So we'll do whatever, yep. So right, yep. You're gonna pair this one to there. So
yep.
Currently I'm okay with this one. So exactly the same process.
Yep.
So you're gonna press that three times.
Three times.
Okay. So that's in pairing mode.
Yep.
I operate my switch. Did the light change on that?
It did, yeah.
That seemed incredibly easy. So if I press it again.
Yep, switch the down. Gone.
Yep, so we got yep. it.
And the, yeah, the down light's gone
so
on.
So let's watch. Okay. Okay. Yeah. They're the wrong way around, though.
They are the wrong way around. Sure, we'll try it. We'll undo it.
Okay, undo yep. the pairing.
So I'll undo the pairing. So again, I put it into three presses.
Okay.
And you press it again.
So mine is on.
Yours is on.
Okay, let's try again. So I press it.
Yep.
Okay, so that's now, they're both off.
They're both off.
Right, aren't they?
Let's have another try. One, two, three. You're in pairing mode.
So I've got to make sure now I press this in the same, so that's positioned there.
Yep, so you're paired up there.
On, off,
yeah.
On, off. Well, that's great. That's just so I've two different, completely different circuits using that technology.
Yeah, and there's obviously other combination you could do, but if you wanted to add multiple switching points in a room instead of having all that intermediate wiring, Gary, I know you like intermediate wiring.
You don't need any cables, intermediate wiring's not needed. Okay, so that's it. That's
so great.
So I would say, I don't want to say entry level, but that's sort of like the first flavouring of it. This is the original version, is it? That radio frequency signal being picked up by a receiver that's simply paired.
Mm.
But we also hinted that there was a Bluetooth version, didn't we, Gordon?
Yeah, and that brings in another degree of control, because obviously you can use an app on a phone. However, it also, I think it makes it easier to commission, because obviously there we're juggling multiple presses of switches in different orders and things like that. Then obviously in this case we had to get inside to put a triggering button in there to get into a setup mode.
Okay.
What we're gonna do now is
we have left this one off, we didn't need to, so let's have a quick look at what we've got here then.
So this is a Kozee controller.
Okay.
So this is a dual output, so it's got two switched outputs.
Okay, two channels then effectively.
Yep, two channels, so it's just again there's our supply in.
Yep.
And then obviously two switched outputs, and I've paired these down to these 5 amp, 5 amp round pin plugs.
Okay.
That I've connected up to two wall lights here.
And you can clearly see on there, kind of on that receiver, the Bluetooth symbol.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to bring in. So let's bring this one back in. So I'm going to bring your phone in.
Yeah.
And you've downloaded. Let's get this clear, because this is an app. We've downloaded the app, and then you're going to do the next thing.
Yeah.
So nothing else. There's no jiggery pokery in here. It's just the next thing. Yeah.
Yeah.
So I'm going to open those in. Let's have a little look. So
I've got your Kozee app.
Okay.
So you can see I've got two light channels on there.
Because it's a two-channel receiver.
Because it's a two-channel receiver. So this is just working on Bluetooth. I haven't had to go on to Wi-Fi. I just...
So if you had no Wi-Fi, it would still work?
Yeah. So you just need Bluetooth. So there's obviously a local connection between the phone and the receiver there. So I'll go in there. You can see on the screen there, I've got channel one and channel two.
Okay.
And there you go. Switch those off.
No.
Switch them back on.
Hang on, whoa, because that's that quick. So there's no edit, there's no cut, there's nothing. That's just that simple. You've automatically now got control.
Yeah.
Okay, I've got a problem. Okay, unless I've got your phone, I'm not going to be able to turn on my wall lights.
You're right. But before I go there, I'm just going to rename channel two as Gary.
Okay, I'm going to be channel two, like it.
Yeah, so I'll just do that. So there you go. I've just renamed there. And I'm going to be going at this side of the bench. Please look, get out of those switches. Okay, done. So yeah, you're right. Obviously, not many people just want to control the lights with an app.
No,
nearly
80.
Middle of the night, you don't want to be searching for your phone when you need to answer that call. So what we're going to do now is we're just going to go in and add some switches.
Okay, add some switches. I've got a switch here. I've made sure I've got the right one.
So this is Gary. Yeah, you're going to add this.
Yeah, I'm going to add this switch. So,
okay,
so
it's a UK style switch. So just press a button. There we go. And right now, press it off. There you go. So I've just added your switch.
No.
So that's it. To the app.
Okay. Have you got one there?
I've got one here. So I'm going to add. I think I want to control your light as well, Gary.
Oh.
So I'll just, again on the app again, I'm just going to add another UK style switch. And there you go. I've got control.
So let me have a go. So I'm on.
Yeah.
You're off. You're back on, and I'm off.
So then, obviously, my side, you can't control this, and I can't control this at the moment, so I'll just add another switch for that.
So you've got a two-gang switch. Let's just have a little look at that, we're going to go there. So let's make that one B. So I'll have a little look at that as well. So, so you're going to add another switch. So you've got a two-gang switch there.
Yeah, there you go.
That was just, hang on, this was pull back. So you've turned in both on, not from your mobile device, which you can do.
Down. Put that down.
Put it down, a little bit of, yeah. Wow.
Yeah. Dead easy. That was, yeah. I mean, we're going to start seeing more Bluetooth control in lighting, because obviously you think the number of devices out there in the world that use Bluetooth. Obviously, yeah. We're thinking about connecting phones to cars.
Yes.
But now we're seeing it in lighting control, and the good thing is, it is obviously a global standard as well.
Yeah.
But that's not it. There is one more flavour of this as well. So we've got a version here. Anyone who's a fan of the Philips Hue,
okay,
which are the obviously the IoT lights from Philips, colour change, you can get garden lights, you can get all sorts.
Yeah.
The RetroTouch range includes what's known as a Friends of Hue, Gary.
All right, so if you're a friend of Hue, that will be able to control that system.
Yeah.
Okay, so we're looking for that on the box, are we?
You're looking for that on the box, so we've got that here.
Look,
so we'll see. There's a Friends of Hue smart switch. So again, it's the battery-free technology.
So if I see that and I've got a Hue product, I can use these EnOcean switches.
Yes.
In this case, we're using the RetroTouch ones in order to control that. So,
yeah.
So hang on, so we're gonna have some beautiful lights maybe from Hue, controlled by these RetroTouch switches that also look beautiful.
Yeah, exactly. And again, it just gives that, and obviously, you know, they're super slim in terms of the switch. If you want to put that on the wall, you've just got this, comes with a double-sided sticky tape.
Okay.
That's in old Blue Peter tradition. So just peel that off, and obviously you can stick that to the wall. But you know, think of the scenarios we've got here, the traditional, the bedside light either there, your light's off there, Gary, brought it back on for you. You know, can really simplify that wiring, can't you?
Yeah, you can. And think about it as raw materials and effort to put cables in. So you're wiring extra circuitry everywhere around to make these switches absolutely where you need them, which then is obviously compromised when, let's go back to that bedroom, you have a reshuffle around, move the bed, you've got those switches chased into the wall, you're sort of locked into that position within that room. So of course that gives you greater flexibility, and the amount of time it takes the electrician to install is greatly reduced, isn't
it? So this is the RetroTouch range with the obviously the glass front panels. I will leave a link in the description for all of the products we've shown here, and obviously the wiring accessories that go with that. And obviously, being a wireless switch expert, Gary will try and answer as many of your comments as he possibly can
and get the switch around the right way as well.